a really ugly turkey sandwich. It is purple.
A police car. So we have King George to thank for preparing a car for me. A pleasant surprise, eh, Zach? Let's take it for a spin. I have to tell you, Zach, this place simply amazes me. The keys were left on the front hood, and nobody stole the car. Values. This town has what the country needs. Values. Let's head over to the sheriff's department.
And this is our map. You would probably like to zoom out some more, but that is not possible. This is as far out as it goes. You can zoom in, but not out. So it takes a little bit of time to get used to the layout of the town. I know I got lost a bunch of times, and the map wasn't much help because I couldn't find myself on the map. Yeah. So it looks like we have to head over to the sheriff's office. If I put the sirens on, I can go up to 60. Oops. Oh, crap. And just like with our life and eating and whatnot.
So, Zach.
I'll let him finish.
About those bonus features in DVDs nowadays.
You know, the ones from the 80s have almost no bonus material. Even if they do, it's a trailer and the visual quality is pretty bad. Well, that visual quality is a good reminder of those days. So many new audio and visual appliances were coming out back then. Do you remember the first video deck we bought? We bought it to record one of the Star Wars movies on TV. And remember when that video store opened, we spent hours there. Just trying to find a good movie to rent. There weren't that many to choose from back then. I remember renting some really bad ones after reading those back cover taglines. Hey, remember? Attack of the Killer Tomatoes? Filmed in 1978. Produced, directed, written, and edited by John DiBello. It was really awful, but for some reason I still remember it pretty well. It had so many sequels, and the original was re-released in 95. The 87-minute-long theatrical release bumped up to a whopping 90 minutes. But that was around the time I joined the Bureau. I never have a chance to see it.
I know, Zach. Once this case is over, we can watch it together.
I bet we can buy a copy on the internet pretty easily.
Okay, like I was saying before, your car has a gauge for gas and damage. If your car runs out of gas, you won't be able to drive it, but you can use a flare to call another police car. And if your car gets all the way down to 0%, York will be taken to the hospital because apparently he's been in an accident. So you want to try not to hit your car, and you want to try to keep it filled up with gas.
Building for such a small town. The exterior woodwork is spectacular. Don't you agree, Zach?
Yeah, I've seen better.
Mm-hmm.
I was awake. Really.
Pleasure to meet you, Agent Morgan. We've been expecting you.
I'm Thomas McLean, the sheriff's assistant.
And I'm fabulous.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please just call me York. It's what everyone else calls me.
Very well then, Agent York.
I believe I owe you a thank you for retrieving my belongings from my car. Thanks.
Oh, no. Just doing my job.
You also put out the fire, apparently.
I want to help do everything I can to help the investigation. I just can't believe Anna was murdered. She was such a bright and lovely girl.
Did you know her well?
Well, no, not really. But it's a very small town. I'm sorry. It's just that this is the first really big case I've ever seen.
I understand. Just try to relax. Can I have a look at Anna's file now?
Yes, of course. The sheriff told me to let you through to the meeting room, but I've lost the key to the cabinet where the files are. Why don't you take a look around while I go look for it?
Okay. Let me know when things are ready.
Zach, Thomas appears to be the kind and sensitive type, totally at odds with the monarch. Almost a good setting for a cartoon.
Yeah, when I first saw that scene, me and my friends were laughing so hard, we had to load it up from a previous save just to watch it again, because we could not believe that Thomas was just really flaming. Okay, I read that that's supposed to be Sweary in the picture next to the dog. I guess I can kind of see a resemblance. Let's see if I can get closer. No, probably not. Hey, dudes. This person probably has nothing to do with the investigation. Well, how do you know? You're not even talking to them. You were just staring at them. Hey, my name's York. What's your name? Some investigator you are. Hey Thomas, how's the search going? Well, maybe if you expanded your search past that shelf, you might. Okay, so we're looking for a key with a southern flying squirrel key holder attached to it. And no, I just got here. A pointy-tailed flying squirrel keys. They're just losing keys all over the place. Ooh, what's this?
A raincoat. Doesn't look like it's been used much, even though it rains here pretty often. What waste of nice fabric, eh, Zach?
Kitchen room. You got the gray squirrel keys. And you got the nasty looking sandwich that's spelled incorrectly card. It was turkey. No, wait, no. Ooh, a dumbbell.
Zach, there's a name written on this dumbbell.
Arnold.
I haven't met anyone by that name yet. Could it be the owner of this dumbbell? What do you think, Zach?
It's not a tumor.
Okay. Office room. Hey, Emily. How you doing? Might want to talk to her. No, wait, no, talk.
Hi.
You know, you could help me look for them.
Hi.
Yes. Could you help me find those keys? What? Yeah, York, we do need help. Why don't you lend Thomas? That's what I'm doing. Looking for that key? I hardly know it. Yeah, I know. Wow, thanks, Emily. Ooh, wait, just mail. Sorry, I'm really busy right now, just standing by my desk. If you have time, honey. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. But you look like I have some good stuff on your desk. Cookies? Can I have one? Hey. Have you seen some keys? No. George! I'm looking for some keys. And you
George,
are
do you
doing
work out
squats.
Of course, Agent Morgan. Exercise keeps me healthy. I haven't missed a day since I started in high school.
Now that's impressive. Remind me to get more exercise, Zach.
But I can't do my full routine today without Arnold. I haven't seen Arnold around since yesterday.
Arnold.
He's a training buddy of mine. His partner Sylvester misses him too. If you see Arnold around, let me know, will ya? Can't finish my workout menu without him.
Okay. I'll keep an eye out for him.
It's okay, I'm sure Sylvester would just go eat at Taco Bell.
Wants to take me to dinner at Taco Bell. The Lord knows it was my burrito. He's also one of the guys who built the goddamn cryo.
Alright, another fun part of this game is the amount of side missions. I think there's like 30. You don't have to do them to complete the game, but I feel that doing them does help your understanding of the town and the people. You get little like inside stories that you wouldn't get if you just followed the main storyline, so I'm going to make sure to go through and complete them all. Just so you can learn more about the citizens in town.